The way that teenagers are communicating has changed dramatically over the past 10, 15 years, and it has been accelerated as of the past 5 years. Social media has permeated the life of all of the teenagers, and we now know that teenagers spend much more time with these devices and in front of the computers than they had ever done before, and that they are communicating much more electronically than on a face-to-face perspective. We knew from all of the epidemiological studies and the studies on adolescents that mirror behaviors of observing other teenagers and the dynamic that exists on peer pressure when you are with other teenagers contributes significantly to the initiation and repeated drug use among adolescents, among teenagers. Very powerful driver. So the question that emerges, and we don't have answers because this has not been investigated, but the question that comes to mind is, could these changes in interaction be playing a role on the decreasing consumption of drugs by teenagers? Because the probability of them being in physical presence of other teenagers has been decreased by the fact that now they are more interacting through the web than in person. That's one. I also think that we need to do research in terms of understanding how other types of reinforcers that teenagers are picking up that did not exist to the same extent among teenagers are actually substituting for the culture of taking drugs. And in particular, for example, the use of video games, which have actually just skyrocketed in terms of technology and the power and drive they have to capture the behavior of teenagers to the point that in certain countries like China, Taiwan, Korea, they have established clinics for treating addiction to these video games among teenagers, because teenagers get compulsive about it and they relinquish their school activity, their social life, and they stop sleeping, and it can be quite harmful. So you are changing the pattern of rewarding compulsive options to teenagers that were not there in the past.